When I came to Canada, I was 12 years old. It was a pretty great culture shock for me, considering that I didn't speak English and I barely knew the alphabet. But when I first came here, a lot of people told me that I would lose my Russian heritage, my Russian culture. A lot of similar experiences have happened to other people in my family, including my cousin, who came here at the age of 7. And I objected to that and basically thought that I'm far too strong a person, as far as my character goes, to totally give up my culture and become totally assimilated by this new country in which I found myself. And I have certain feelings of nostalgia about my childhood memories, my places where I grew up. If I could, I would go there, just like at the moment's notice, just pack my bags, go there. Because it's basically like another lifetime for me. It's like, if you believe in reincarnation, I had a life in Russia, then basically death after that life, by coming, which is could be signified by me coming over here, the journey itself, and then rebirth by me basically arriving. I am, of course, I am a person of mixed backgrounds, mixed race, so that basically allows me to identify with a great many people, and it gives me a unique perspective and also an ability to socialize, relate, and identify with just about everyone. That also gives me a unique perspective on humanity as a whole, because I think that every human being is just like me. There's to think that a certain group of people is any different from any other group of people, I believe it's a kind of a delusion, because there isn't a single group of people that I can basically exclude myself from, and there's also no definite group of people that I can include myself or fully identify with, simply because I am not a uniracial person. And I think that's just gives me an outside perspective on humanity as a whole, and basically what enriches my life, just my ability to see things that other people may not allow themselves to see, simply because they're so sometimes self-centered or they're too pride-filled of their own culture, their own background. They may see others as a lesser race or a lesser culture, and even if I wanted to do something like that, I wouldn't have the luxury to do that, because I can't be nationalistic or racist in the slightest way, because I am of many cultures, and it's the joining of all those cultures that made my existence possible. That's what basically matured me at the early age, because I was able to see how certain people are arrogant, some people are ignorant, and some people are just evil for the sake of being evil, as just the same as some people are good for the sake of being good. I believe that being Canadian is it's certainly not a nationality like it may be with other countries, some European countries. So being Canadian means, to me, it basically means being open-minded, being able to coexist and correlate to other human beings, to other cultures, being flexible with others, being non-judgmental of others. And the notion of being Canadian has been founded by people from other countries, from other cultures and backgrounds and religions, and the whole core of Canada basically signifies the mixture of cultures, and in a positive way. It basically serves as an example to the rest of the world how different cultures can coexist in this almost utopian society, in a peaceful manner, in a humane manner, in a fully non-malicious way.